of the topics that's been going on out here this week has been cyber liability insurance, or just cyber insurance in general. How important is that going to be in the coming next couple of years?
Yeah, I think it's going to be super important, because when we see like these liability cases are starting to happen as real world damages happen from breaches, you know, we saw Wyndham Hotels, the FTC found them liable for poor security. We see like in Target, community banks are suing Target for their costs. So it's liability is happening. And the question is, who's going to decide, you know, when you have negligent security or you have good security, right? Is it going to be the FTC regulators? Is it going to be the courts? Or it could perhaps be the market through cyber insurance. So I just think cyber insurance is going to play an important role in determining, you know, what does it mean to be liable for a breach, or when could it have not have been prevented?
So where do you see that determination coming from? I mean, are the insurance companies basically going to dictate to everyone what you need to have for bare minimums? Is that even possible?
Yeah, so in the Wyndham Hotel case, we saw that Wyndham Hotel said, you know, we can't be negligent because there was no standards that we had to follow. Like, there was nothing that the FTC wrote down that said, like, we had to do this, so how can you hold us liable? The court didn't buy that because, you know, there's basic common sense things you need to do, right? The thing is codifying those common sense things. So I think the cyber insurance industry will do that because they don't want to pay out if someone has no security program, right? They're going to expect you to have a certain level of security, just like, you know, if you have fire insurance and you have a commercial business, you have to have sprinklers, you have to have, you know, exit doors. Like, there are certain requirements, and if you don't have those things, the insurance company won't pay out, right? So I think what's going to happen is they're going to look in retrospect after the breach and say, should we pay this claim? Right? Did they follow reasonable standards? And I think they're going to have to sort of dictate what those standards are to some extent.
So a couple of months ago, late last year, there was a case of cyber insurance where the company had made a claim, and the insurance was like, well, yes, you suffered a breach, but no, we only cover you. We don't cover your business partner, who's actually the reason of this breach.
Right.
How important are those little nuances and clauses in the insurance company's, you know, documents? How important are they to the actual business?
Yeah, I mean, to anyone who's actually filed a claim with an insurance company, you know that the details matter, right? Like, you know, which side of the wall was a problem on and for some home claim. Like, the details definitely do matter. And so it is still evolving. I don't think we know what all those details are yet. I don't think the insurance companies know what they are. So, you know, for example, I've seen cyber insurance that specifies things like it covers insider threat too. So you actually have to specify that, because it'd be like, wait a minute, it was one of your own employees that caused this problem, right? Does it handle, you know, human error, right? Or is it only handling sort of the cyber attacker? So I think the details are going to matter.
So if a company's interested in this type of insurance or this product, what are some basics they need to look for before they actually go out and start spending money on it?
Yeah, I think you have to start studying like the breaches maybe in your peers and see what their damages were. What were they held liable for? You know, there's some things that you're not going to be able to really cover, like, you know, your brand damage, right? And that varies by company, it varies by brand. But they're, you know, number two on the, we did a survey with boards of directors, and they said that the number two concern of after a breach of hurting a company is the brand damage, right? I don't think you can cover that, but you can say, like, you know, what is being covered? Is it like business disruption? My breach costs, I had to hire lawyers, I had to hire incident response people, I had PR expenses, right? Those hard costs. And then you probably have to think about those downstream costs, because even if I'm covered with cyber insurance, I might be found liable for someone else's damages, like you're saying, like the community banks and things like that. So is that going to be covered? So, I mean, all those things being covered is probably going to jack up the cost. You're going to have to make, you know, trade-offs, thinking your industry, what's likely to happen to me.
Excellent. Thanks, Chris.
Okay.